Insects and worms have come on Earth much before the dinosaurs, which is more than 480 million of years ago, or maybe due to insects, forests are produced, and they are the majority of Earth's biomass. Nature has given certain amazing abilities to the worms, like if we cut a planarian worm into multiple pieces. Each piece will then make all of its tissues, brains, and eyes, and start functioning like a perfect animal. Some species of planaria eat earthworms. When we cut an earthworm in two, it may not become two new worms. The head of the worm may survive if it is cut behind the clitellum and regenerate its tail, but the tail part cannot regenerate and will die. A tiny invertebrate planarian flatworm is able to regenerate its entire body when cut into two. The most interesting fact is, after its head regrows, with all its old memories in the new fresh head, even if there was no brain tissue retained in the decapitated worm. The acoles, which are the very small flattened worms, under 2 mm in length, but some larger species may reach up to 15 mm in length, can fully regenerate. Each piece of the animals can grow fully, with entirely new brains and muscles, and have the ability to regenerate when cut into multiple pieces. Earthworms are nature's little plows, which helps in increasing the air and water circulation in the soil. After feeding on organic matter, like leaves and grass, earthworms produce excreta, called vermicast, which is an organic fertilizer, rich in humus, NKP, potassium nitrate, micronutrients, soil microbes. Earthworms' casts help rebuild topsoil, and famous as nature's first gardener. Without insect, food cannot be produced on Earth, and perished material cannot be recycled. Insects are essential for both plants and animals. In simple words, plants, birds and animals cannot survive without insects, but without birds and animals, Earth with the help of insects can still produce productive crops, as they are the direct and immediate link who pollinate plants and are responsible for producing all the foods on Earth. Pollination is vital for the existence on Earth. Pollinators like bees have been thriving for more than thousands of years, are securing the food system and maintaining vibrant ecosystems. Bees are said to have good color vision and get attracted by colored flowers of blue, purple, violet, white, and yellow. Bees can help increase yield and productivity of a vegetation firm by up to 80%. The largest group of all insects are beetles, and 30% of insects are beetles. Ladybugs are the most beloved and respected of insects, which are a group of beetles. Larvae of ladybugs, and as adults, prey on pests and help keep pests under control. It is nature's insecticides. Ladybugs can consume 50 to 60 aphids per day. Aphids are destructive pests which can destroy our vegetation. With more than 5,000 species of ladybugs, which feed on different kind of plant-eating insects, protects our crops naturally. We all know that if a fruit is not eaten by an insect, then it is not safe and healthy for humans to consume. All insects are not pests, but all pests may be insects. Many of us may think a snail is insect, but a snail is not an insect, as it belongs to phylum Mollusca, which set them apart from insect, but very close to insect. During the year 2019, there was a news about a 19-year-old Australian rugby player who became paralyzed after eating a slug and also remained paralyzed for 420 days. Snails and slugs are similar animals and are not dangerous, but they can be harmful if they carry a parasitic nematode. The main difference between them is that a snail has a shell and a slug does not.